We want to make sure that nobody's going to get hurt or killed, because some of the experience of dealing with maximum security inmates is not common to high desert.
So what's he talking about? He's talking about a prisoner swap. It is set to happen between High Desert State Prison here in Southern Nevada and Ely State Prison in Central Nevada. It would bring maximum security inmates and others from Ely to about 35 miles outside of Las Vegas, and it would send an estimated 12 to 1,400 offenders to Ely. But the president of the union representing corrections officers questions this transition, telling News 3 it is happening too fast. He worries about the safety of corrections officers and inmates as well.
Krista Drummond joins us now in the studio after speaking to the president today. And what is he telling you about his concerns?
Well, he is concerned about the training, the staffing, and making sure those correctional officers have the proper equipment to not only do the transportation, but be a part of this transition. Of course, High Desert is the state's largest prison. The union president tells me he's met with NDOC officials, even having a meeting with the labor relations unit yesterday, as well as bringing the issue up with the governor's office. He says concerns are not being addressed before High Desert becomes a maximum security prison here in Nevada.
This is extremely frustrating to me.
But it caused Paul Lunkwit's plans to fight.
Their ideas and the plan sounds fine, but we're not there yet, so why are we jumping the gun?
He's a union president representing corrections officers with the Fraternal Order of Police, now questioning the Nevada Department of Corrections. Lunkwit says NDOC plans a prison swap, moving about 500 maximum security inmates and others from Ely State Prison to High Desert State Prison just outside Las Vegas, a place he says is not ready for the transition.
They're not doing a comprehensive training, and they haven't even done it for every officer at that yard yet, because training is needed. Maximum security inmates, close custody inmates that, you know, can't live in any other population of offenders, there's a different way that they're handled.
News 3 obtaining a copy of Lunkwitz's letters to the labor relations unit demanding to bargain over safety implications, writing there's a lack of equipment, lack of training curriculum, and no time frame within which these safety measures will be implemented before the move occurs.
We need to have the ability to put a stop to bad situations that happen quickly. In microseconds, we have to make decisions, and we have to have that equipment available for us in order to maintain the best control that we can.
News 3 learning about the planned move about a month after a deadly prison riot at Ely. Three inmates killed, including a white supremacist gang leader. So why move these violent inmates down south? Well, Lunkwit says Ely is notoriously difficult to staff as well as recruit and retain employees, but not so much at High Desert.
The ability to add staff in the south has been very good.
Not enough, though, for max security, according to Lunkwit. He says High Desert needs about an additional 60 positions, likely not filling up until later this year when more academies graduate. He also says some of the facility needs work,
because they are in a bad state of repair and they need to be reinforced. They need to be repaired properly, and they need to take this stuff seriously.
Lunkwit wants to negotiate, ensuring inmates and COs stay safe from transportation to transition.
If one of our people gets hurt or killed, or an inmate gets killed, that blood is on your hands, because we have brought these things to your attention.
Now Lunkwit's raising these safety concerns after an inmate attempted to escape just yesterday from High Desert. He says the offender almost got out near an unmanned watchtower. The person is back in custody now and in segregation. Lunkwit says NDOC tells him the towers will be manned 24/7 once High Desert becomes a high security prison. I did reach out to NDOC as well as the governor's office for comment about the transition, but no official response at this time. Dana LaToya.
Big changes. Never had these kinds of changes before here in Nevada. So it'll be interesting to see how it works out. Kristen, thank you.